There is a place on Earth with such high temperature and humidity conditions that if you were to stay there for more than about 20 minutes, you could drown in the vapors of your own breath. I'm talking about the giant cave of crystals in Naica, Mexico. In today's video, we will learn about the crystal cave and we will see what is so special about the crystals in this cave. Hello and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, I'm Maria and I'm a scientist and a sci-fi fantasy writer sharing with you the wonders of our world. In today's video, we'll explore together one of our natural heritage sites, the Naica Cave of Crystals. We will learn about the special crystals that grow in this cave, we'll have a look at the environmental conditions that led to the growth of the crystals, and of course, we will see what these crystals are made of. And if you stay until the end, I will explain what I meant by drowning in your own breath. But let's start first by exploring the cave. Imagine being one of the miners excavating a mountain for minerals, and when digging a new tunnel, you come across this place that looks like Superman's cave. Can you imagine being there? Though completely immersed in water in the beginning, when the miners pumped out the water from the cave, it felt like they were walking through this alien landscape.
The Cave of Crystals is home to these enormous crystals that weigh up to about 40 to 50 tons and have grown to about 12 meters in length and 1 meter in width. You can get an idea about the size of these crystals when you look at the person standing next to them. Would you like to be standing next to these crystals?
I know I would! And I wouldn't mind meeting Superman there as well. But, as I mentioned in the beginning, it's not exactly a friendly environment. It's not an environment suited for a holiday, but an environment suited for the growth of these crystals. To understand how these enormous crystals were formed, we first have to understand the geology of the region. The Giant Cave of Crystals is located about 290 meters underground, beneath a mineral-rich mountain close to Naica in the state of Chihuahua, Mexico. This mountain was born about 26 million years ago when magma raised to the Earth's surface. When that happened, the caves beneath this mountain filled with water rich in minerals. And the mineral that found the environment of this cave perfect to flourish was selenite. Let's have a look at selenite chemistry and see what is selenite and what are the selenite crystals. Selenite is a form of gypsum. Well, I'm sure that clarified everything. Okay, so let's see first what is gypsum then.
Gypsum is a sulfate mineral with the chemical formula you see on the screen. It is called calcium sulfate dihydrate. What this means is that for every calcium sulfate molecule in the structure, we find two water molecules. This is the unit cell of gypsum. You can think of the unit cell as the basic unit of the gypsum crystal. Here we can see the calcium atoms, the sulfate groups, and the water molecules. When we multiply this unit cell in all the directions in space, we create the gypsum crystal. The more of these cells we add, the larger the crystal grows. And when the gypsum crystal grows, we get one of these beautiful minerals that we can often admire in the mineral sections in museums.
I always love looking at minerals. I find it inspiring to see the beautiful structures that nature creates with the help of chemistry. The gypsum crystals can vary from colorless, clear crystals to white crystals, though sometimes there can be other hues when there are certain impurities present in the crystal structure. The ones we're interested in here are the clear crystals, and those are the ones that we refer to as selenite. Its chemical formula is the same as gypsum, but the difference between these two minerals come from the way and the shapes under which the crystals grow.
We've seen that gypsum can form flower-like patterns, while selenite can form columns. And it's the latter ones that we find in the Cave of Crystals in Naica, Mexico. Now that we've seen what these huge crystals in the Naica Cave are, let's see how they managed to grow so big. When magma raised to the surface forming the mountain, the caves beneath the mountain filled with hot, mineral-rich water. The predominant mineral was anhydrite. Anhydrite is a calcium sulfate mineral that doesn't contain water molecules, whereas gypsum is formed by bringing together calcium sulfate and water molecules. Anhydrite is stable above 58 degrees Celsius, while gypsum is stable below 58 degrees. In time, as the temperature started slowly decreasing below 58 degrees, anhydrite began dissolving into calcium and sulfate, creating a slightly supersaturated solution containing these ions. These ions then combined with the water molecules and started forming small selenite crystals. The low levels of supersaturation were ideal for the growth of few but large crystals. On top of that, the temperature just below 58 degrees, ideal for the transition from anhydrite to selenite, promoted the growth of selenite crystals. All in all, the cave environment ensured crystals growing larger and larger over time to form these huge selenite crystals that we see in the giant cave of crystals today.
Let's talk a bit about the temperature and humidity conditions in this cave. I lived in Abu Dhabi for 6 years. While Abu Dhabi can be heaven during winter time, summer can be a bit difficult to handle. With temperatures going as high as 45 degrees Celsius, that's about 113 Fahrenheit, and humidity levels of about 80%, breathing can become a real challenge, especially if you have asthma and you're already having difficulties breathing. So if I consider 80% humidity as a nightmare, I can't imagine what it feels like at close to 100% humidity. To get an idea what that means, staying in that environment for more than a few minutes without any kind of protective equipment, you could actually drown in your own breath. That's because of the difference in temperature between the temperature of the human body and the temperature inside the cave. The average normal temperature of a human body is about 36.5 degrees Celsius, so that would be around 98 degrees Fahrenheit. So the human body temperature is much lower compared to that of the cave environment. That means that the air you're breathing is hotter than the inside of your lungs. In these conditions, the humidity from the hot air will start condensing in your lungs. The fluid buildup in your lungs can lead to lung failure, and that can cause death if there's no immediate medical intervention. So if you want to go there, you have to wear protective cooling gear, and even with the protective equipment, you can still only stay there for about 20 to 30 minutes. Despite all that, it would be so cool to visit the Cave of Crystals, even for just a few minutes. Do you agree? Let me know in the comments below if you would also like to visit the Naica Cave. However, even if we wanted to visit the giant crystal cave and had the proper authorization, we would have to wait for a very long time for our visit because the cave is flooded again. The good news about the reflooding is the fact that the crystals are protected again because they are back in their preferred growth environment. If you want to learn more about the giant crystal cave or the minerals I talked about today, I added some resources for you in the video description. I hope you enjoyed learning about these giant selenite crystals. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos from the wonders of our world. Bye! See you next time!